In this video, we're going to finish the scientific notation worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. Now, our directions for the second page are to write each number in standard notation. So essentially, we're going to work out the multiplication. In number 17, it says 0.9 times 10 to the negative 1. So we're going to take that decimal and we're going to move it once to the left. So our standard notation is 0.09. In number 18, we have the whole number 2, and we're multiplying that by 10 to the negative 1. So we're going to be moving that decimal place over once to the left. So that's 0.2. In number 19, we have 2 times 10 to the 5th. So that's taking the whole number 2, and we're going to be moving the decimal place 5 times. But note that this is a positive 5, unlike the previous two problems where we had a negative exponent. So we're going to be moving the decimal place to the right, since it's a positive exponent. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times to the right, and we're going to fill in those places with zeros. So 2 times 10 to the 5th is 200,000. At number 20, I have 804 times 10 squared, or essentially 804 times 100. Or we can think of this as moving the decimal place over 2 times to the right. So that's 80,400. In number 21, again, we have a positive exponent associated with 10. So we're going to be moving our decimal place over 4 times to the right. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. So putting in zeros as placeholders, that's 26,600. In number 22, we have 1.5 times 10 to the negative 2. Now that it's negative, we're going to be moving our decimal place to the left. So once and twice moved, we'll have 0.015. In number 23, we're moving our decimal place over once to the left. So that will be 0.775. In number 24, we're moving our decimal place 7 times to the right, since it's a positive exponent. So we're going to take 8.3 and move it once, 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, 6 times, 7 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros on the end. So that's 83 million. And number 25. Again, we're moving our decimal place 7 times to the right. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros after 95. So that's 95 million. And again, we're moving it 7 times to the right in number 26. So we're going to take 1.71 and move the decimal place once, 2 times, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this time we're going to be adding 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros onto the end of 171. So now we're going to have 17,100,000. And number 27. We have 9 tenths, and we're multiplying that by 10 to the negative 3. So we're going to be moving our decimal place to the right 3 times. So that's 1, 2, 3, and then fill in my placeholder zeros. So 0.0009. In number 28, we're going to be moving our decimal place 2 times to the right. So that's going to be 3,800. For number 7, we're moving our decimal 5 times to the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. So that's 0.1234 zeros. And then 7, 5. 0.000075. And number 30, we're multiplying 4 by 10 to the 0. So we're moving the decimal place 0 times, or essentially multiplying by 1. So our answer is 4. In number 31, we're moving the decimal place 5 times to the right, since it's a positive 5. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we're going to fill in with zeros, so we have 840,000. And lastly, in this video and on this worksheet, number 32. We have 4 times 10 to the negative 5th, so we're taking that number 4 and moving the decimal place 5 times to the left. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we'll have 0.00004. So 4 zeros after the decimal place and then the 4. And with that final answer, we wrap up this worksheet. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And if you haven't done so already, please take the time to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and share this with your classmates.